Welcome to this masterclass exclusive for the Virtual Property Show by Private Property. My name is Carlo Mariani. I'm the chief hacker of the Property Hacked Club and the founder of the Property Coach. And today I'm bringing you a masterclass called Property Hackers, 5 Actions to Fast Track Your Property Success. So what do you need to do to fast track your property success? Well, before I go any further, I think it's only good that I introduce myself, I introduce my family, you know, meet me, meet my wife Zinchle, meet my only son Daba, and meet some of my properties. What you see here in this picture is like my assets, my most important assets, which is family first and foremost and property. Today I'm here as a property practitioner, as a local property investor, you know, since 2003, and see some of the pictures there, you know, of properties that I currently own, because the one strategy I want to share with you today is focus on orderly properties for orderly South Africans. That is going to be the key strategy that is guaranteed to fast track your property success for at least the next 18 months. And during the course of this masterclass, I'm going to take you through step by step, you know, the actions that you must take and the expensive mistakes that you must avoid to make sure that you're going to have great success with property, right? So, you know, today I'm here as the chief hacker of the Property Hackout Club. So, you know, what is the definition of a property hacker? Well, it's quite simple and it's quite powerful. A property hacker is somebody that always buys the right property at the right price in the right area, without needing her own money, without needing her or his own money. That's the definition of a property hacker, somebody that doesn't want to wait 55, 60, 65 to see the results, the cash flow, the wealth, you know, that you can generate by investing in residential property in South Africa today. You know, like I've done, I've been here since 1999, full time. I'm 100% South African, I'm 100% Italian. That's my backyard. So anyway, you know, you're here today because you want to get 5 actions to fast track your property success. And first and foremost, you know, I'd like us to reconnect with a very powerful message that Patrice Motsepe shared with us some time ago, which is education is at the heart of achieving your dreams, okay? Don't worry about money, don't worry about anything else. At this point in time, education is the heart of achieving your dreams. That is really the essence of the Property Hackout Club. And if education is at the heart of achieving your dreams, what is hack number one for you today? Hack number one today is avoid expensive mistakes at auctions. Because I come across a lot of aspiring and a lot of growing property investors that come to me and says, Carlo, don't stress, I will go to auction and I will pick up a few bargains. And that is when, you know, a lot of people make a very expensive mistakes, because when it comes to property, there are two sides to the same coin. Now, one is price and the other one is terms and conditions. And we seem to like quite willingly and happily forget about terms and conditions of auctions. So I'm going to bring to your attention, and I hope you brought in pen and paper at this virtual property show, because there are 3 things that I want you to write down. Number one is the ROICOP clause. Number two is the confirmation period. And number three is the occupation clause. Now, unfortunately, you know, private property is only giving me 20 minutes for this masterclass before we go live into Q&A. So we're gonna be able to cover this more in detail later on. But the one that I want to cover is the occupation clause. Now, the very vast majority of the standard terms and conditions that you're going to sign in order for you to get a bidder's card at auction, whether it's private auction, whether it's sheriff auction, will not warrant vacant occupation, which basically means that you can buy a property which is perfectly sort of like illegally occupied, and that is going to be your problem to fix. And I call it the Maria clause. Why do I call it the Maria clause? Because Maria came to one of our events, you know, last year in tears. And she said to me, Carlo, you wouldn't believe, but last week, for the first time after 3 years since I bought a property in auction, I've taken occupation of the property, because she got a great deal in terms of price, but She didn't realize she bought a property which is illegally occupied by a Pakistani crime ring, and it took her 3 years to get rid of them. It took her 3 years to get money, the first money ever to actually take occupation of the property. So hack number one, take care, be careful. Auctions, you know, double-edged sword, is not just about the price, it's about terms and conditions, right? So where is the opportunity? Well, I've got good news. You know, all of you that are going to visit us at the virtual property booth or property stand, you're going to get free access to one of my favorite courses that I've shot. Is a video course, 1 hour of tips on auctions, opportunity or scam, or both. Get the answer in the video course. Come and visit us. And hack number two for you today is play the team game. So, you know, what do you need to fast track your property success? What do you need to succeed to have a successful property business? Whether you're investing your name, whether you invest in a trust, you invest in a PTY, it doesn't matter. It's the same five things. Number one, you need access to other people's money. Number two, you need time. Number three, you need knowledge. Number four, you need a team. And number five, you need the willingness and the preparedness to take action. So none of you, including me, never ever had all of these five things at the same time in abundance. One or more of them, you either not gonna have it at all, or you're not gonna have a lot of it, okay? So, and that is a key mistake that too many aspiring and growing property investors, the same aspiring growing property investors we help through the Property Hack Dog Club, they get stuck, okay? Maybe you don't have the money, maybe you don't have the credit record, the access to other people's money, maybe you don't have time, doesn't matter. Play the team game so that when you've got a shortage, or where you've got a deficiency, you can bring in expertise, you can bring in resources and capacity that are going to help you to actually round up this thing called property business. So play the team game, because, you know, at the core of the foundation of the philosophy of the Property Hack Dog Club that I'm sharing with you is, if you want to go fast, go on your own, but you're going to stop at 2, 3, 4 properties, maybe one property, like 95% of South African property investors do. But if you want to go far, the African proverb reminds us that, you know, you gotta go with somebody. You gotta go with somebody. And that's really, you know, part of the so the value we're bringing into the Property Hack Dog Club. And I wanna give you an example, okay? Because, you know, avoid do it yourself. Avoid doing yourself at all costs when it comes to you raising money. Because raising money, it's a critical skill, and it's a critical success factor if you want to become a successful property hacker. And I know that, you know, some of you are making terrible mistakes in terms of how you go about raising money. So for example, I know a lot of you always come with a question to say, you know, how do I raise money in a PTY Limited when, you know, I don't have a trading record of 2 years, trading track record of 2 years in the company. And I want to tell you that 90% of the applications, you know, that, you know, our money raising service partner process successfully is done for companies that are actually brand new shelf companies. So that is an example, but I want to give you an example that, you know, touched me and shaped my life, my career as a property investor. You know, I've been here since 99, you know, but around about 2005, 2015, 2016, you know, I wanted to do, Coley, a portfolio refinancing of some of the properties that I've purchased during the 2008 and 2009 crisis. And that's going to be a story that I'm going to share with you in detail later on in this masterclass. So I approached the bank and I got declined. I got declined. And, you know, most banks, and I'm not going to mention the bank here, but what I can mention to you is that, you know, one of the powers of the Property Hack Dog Club is that we are independent. You know, we don't have financial institutions as sponsors. We don't have like sponsors. So that way we can call it jack to jack, spade to spade. And my first advice is, don't get married to your bank. Don't get married to your bank. In HFS, fire your private banker. Because when I did that, you know, I got declined. And then 3 months later, I got declined again, okay? At that point in time, I reconnected with what Albert Einstein shared with us to say, if you want to achieve different results, you gotta do things differently. And that's a reflection for all of you here that are watching this masterclass to say, you know, if you want to fast track your property success, isn't it time for you to do something different? Isn't it time for you to do something different? So when I got declined the third time, I decided, no, you know, I'm not going to be stopped by rejection. And by the way, property hackers, you know, don't be afraid of rejection, embrace rejection, because I got rejected many, many times. But at some stage, you got to do things differently. And that's when I used the services of a money raising expert. And I'm going to share with you how a money raising expert is different, you know, from a bond originator. A money raising expert that actually helped me compiling my financial circumstances, especially for those of you that are self-employed, especially for those of you that are entrepreneurs like me, especially for those of you that earn irregular income, you gotta use the service of a money raising expert. And when I did that, eventually, not only got my application approved, but I got my application approved for a higher loan to value that I actually originally asked for. And you know what? You know what is the shocking, shocking thing about this entire story? That the same bank that declined me on attempt one and attempt two actually approved me on attempt three when I did it differently, through using the same money raising service expert and expertise that you will get access to, you know, through, you know, your membership of the Property Head Dog Club. So what's the moral of the story here? Very powerful. Number one, use time and expertise you don't have for free. Okay, that's very important. You only get one chance to make a great first impression. If you're gonna go to the bank and you don't know how to package your circumstances, you're going to blow it, and it's going to be very difficult to then reapply on the basis of different circumstances. You've blown it. You might have to wait 6 months before you can do it again. And in the meanwhile, you might have missed out on one of the biggest window of opportunities to buy properties in South Africa, like now. The time to buy property is not just now. It's not now. It's now, kona manje. And number three, make banks compete for your business, because by doing so, you're gonna get massive reductions in interest rates and you're gonna save a ton of money. So that's basically, you know, I think it's hack number three of five actions for you to fast track your property success. And by the way, don't forget to come and join us at our virtual stand. Visit our virtual stand and you're gonna win one of three one-on-one coaching sessions with me, where I'm gonna sit down with you, I'm gonna look at your circumstances, I'm going to give you very practical advice on what is the right strategy is gonna work for you, and address all the questions you've got for me. But only if you come and join us at the virtual stand, you're gonna stand a chance. And the other number four is hack the property sources, okay? You know, property is big money, and when there's big money, the property sources are there. So how do you protect yourself from the property sources? Well, obviously with knowledge, but I wanna give you something even more specific and more detailed. I want to tell you that one way I protect myself, one way all the members of the Property Head Dog Club protect themselves, is through Lightstone Property. Lightstone Property is an absolutely invaluable tool for people that want to operate like professionals, even if they're not doing it full time. Okay, so why do I use Lightstone and why you should do the same? Number one, Lightstone, literally using a phone, is going to tell me who is the registered owner of the property. Is there one registered owner, two registered owners, three more than registered owners, a PTY, a company, an ID number? Then, okay, so I'm already know that I'm dealing with the right person. And very often there is situations where one of the owners is trying to sell the property without the knowledge of the other person. So protect yourself. Number two, that report, which I can actually pull out on my iPhone, you know, while I'm outside the property, is gonna tell me how much the property was bought for, when was it bought for, Is there any servitude that I should be aware of? Is there any maybe attachment to the property? And is there a bond, and how much was the bond registered for? So this is all invaluable information you can get literally within 30 seconds for you to take the profit without the risks, you know, by using the same tools. And by the way, you know, when you join the Property Hedgehog Club, you will get access to Lifestone Property as one of the many benefits, you know, of your membership. So that is Koli hack number 4. Hack number 5, hack the pandemic, the crisis, the prophets of doom. I've been here since 99. I cannot remember the people that told me that, you know, properties are too expensive, South Africa is going to go to the pits. And thanks God, I completely ignore them, because history doesn't repeat itself, but it rhymes. So what do I mean by that? Look at this. This is the story of property prices in South Africa for the last 55 years. And look at that. 95% of the time, property prices are going up. And every time property prices are going down, see what happens? Boom! You know, property prices are shooting back up. They're shooting back up quite quickly, quite rapidly, and always to a multiplier of whatever they've gone down to, okay? Are the property prices going down? Possibly. You know, the market has been incredibly resilient. You know, long live the property market. It takes more than Corona to kill the property market in South Africa. So is this a big crisis? Yes, it's a big crisis. Is this a big opportunity? It's a massive opportunity for those with the right knowledge, the right tools, you know, the right collaboration platform, the right access to the team that, you know, the fast track team that you're going to get access through conveyances, money raising experts, property inspectors, rates troubleshooters, access to one-on-one coaching. And I'm gonna conclude today to show you how I fast-tracked my property success using the 2008-2009 crisis. Well, I'm gonna give an example. This is one of the properties that I showed you earlier on, and bought a sectional title in South Africa, in Sandton, 2008, 430,000 square rand with a 90% bond. Again, ordinary properties for ordinary South Africans. 32 square meters, one bedroom, richest square mile in South Africa. And because I bought the right property at the right price in the right area, like property hackers do, look at what I did. You know, 2016, through the sheer art of doing very little, property value is 785,000 rand. That's a nice, at that point in time, I go back to the bank. The bank values the property for 765,000 rand, gives me a bond for the 100%. And I have cash in the bank for 453,000 rand, 0% tax legally. If you want to get more of these, and if you want to get basically more detailed explanation on how you can do exactly the same, you know, the key question for me is quite simple. You know, are you committed to turn the pandemic into the biggest property opportunity of your life? Because the Chinese says to know and not to do is to not know. Okay, so today you're coming, you visit the virtual property show, you get a lot of knowledge, but nothing happens unless you take action. And if you're prepared to take some action, come and visit us, you know, learn more about the Property Hack Club. You know, we're an independent provider of property education, provide online education, tools, the network, the collaboration platform, the fast track team for you to fast track your property success. And you know, we are all about teaching you how to fish. We don't sell properties. We don't market properties. We don't resell properties. We are helping you to empower yourself to fast track your property success. So meet me at our virtual stand. I've got free knowledge. Don't forget, come and join me. You get access to our video course, auction, scams of opportunity. Plus, I've got a crazy offer for you to join the Property Hedgehog Club, and you're going to stand a chance to win 1 or 3 coaching sessions with me, valued each at 2,000 rand each. And to conclude, you can have property investments or you can have excuses, but you cannot have both. And I'm looking forward to our Q&A live, you know, and I'll see you right away. Ciao from Carlo, founder of the Property Coach and chief hacker of the Property Hedgehog Club. I will see you in our Q&A live session. Ciao.